Does your skin feel like it is so dry that it feels like a statue that is cracking? So perpetually dry, cracked skin may be lacking vitamin F, otherwise known as EFAs or essential fatty acids. Now we cannot produce vitamin F in our own bodies, and it's very important to our skin. Vitamin F is essential for our bodies, especially when creating new skin. It actually helps regulate cholesterol production. And when I say cholesterol, I don't mean in your blood. It's actually in our skin. And a precursor of prostaglandin, which basically helps heal our skin or any tissue damage. Hi, my name is Christy, and I have been professionally treating clients for over 12 years, especially in the areas of hyperpigmentation, acne, fine lines and wrinkles, and other skin conditions. So if you're new here, now I retired last December, my brick and mortar practice, and so now we're doing online consultations. If this is the first time viewing most of my videos, the links and descriptions for clinical studies, products, anything like that will always be in the description below. So today we're going to be talking about vitamin F in regards to fine lines and wrinkles. So in regards to the fine lines and wrinkles, wrinkles are basically scarring of the skin where it has lost its elasticity and breakdown of collagen. So the repeated folding and crinkling of the skin every time you smile or laugh or frown, it eventually leads to wrinkles. So vitamin F actually helps prevent the repeated tissue injury. Here are some foods that you can get vitamin F from. Fishy fish, such as salmon, tuna, or mackerel, as well as shellfish, and sesame seeds, flax seeds, chia seeds, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, walnuts, and the oils would be hemp, soybean, and canola, as well as leafy greens. So let's say you don't like seafood or fishy fish. You can actually take a supplement here that is rich in omega-3 fish oils. And for those of you who are vegan, we also offer this option as well. So for those of you who don't like those fishy fish burps, you may want to try the vegan option. Now, some of them actually are mixed or combined with vitamin E oil, and some of them even have vitamin A, C, and E, and calcium or iron. First, before I forget, I do want to thank a viewer, Mimi Dishes. She had suggested or wanted me to do a video on more of how diet affects the skin. So if you're liking some of this information, please give us a thumbs up to let us know this is some more information that you would find helpful. The link between diet of what you eat and skin aging was done on a study in 2008 on 4,025 women between the ages of 40 and 74. This data comes from the first National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey. Now, this particular study that I'm going to be talking about was doing a study of women who they introduced a higher linoleic acid diet and what it did on dry, mature, atrophied skin. So this study was done on 13 patients, and what happened when they had UVB induced sun rash on their skin, and they also took a supplement for 3 months of fish oil. So when they were exposed to the UVB, what they found is after taking these supplements that actually they had a reduction of the UVB induced sun rash, as well as faster healing. Now, on a side note, they also noticed that they also had a significant reduction in skin wrinkles and an improved skin elasticity. Now, there was another study that was done. Now, this time this was done on the skin of hairless mice. And basically, they were fed an oral supplement of vitamin C, E, pycnogenol, and evening primrose oil. And what they saw was an improvement in collagen synthesis. When they were exposed to UVB rays, it actually showed a lower rate of inflammation and increased elasticity. Now, if you feel like you have chronically dry, cracking skin, here is the pro tip. The pro tip is, yes, absolutely take some supplements in your diet, both with foods and supplements, as well as topically. And the reason why is, it takes a while of eating this food regularly for it to actually start to show externally on your skin. So in the meanwhile, if you have dry, cracked skin, you want to apply some of this vitamin F or essential fatty acids onto your skin. So here are some examples. So here's the first one. This is going to be a level 3 moisturizer. And if you don't know what I mean by that, please check out this video right up here that explains the differences of level 1, 2, and 3 for dry skin. So this is a level 3, and it is right here. This is a cold pressed sunflower oil. You have to make sure that it is all sunflower oil, because what I noticed in looking at the different sunflower oils, sometimes they mix it in with canola oil or vegetable oil. It doesn't specify. So you want to get the cold pressed one, and especially one that actually says you can be used as a carrier oil, can be used on skin, hair, and massage. Now, you have to be careful, because some of the food grade sunflower oil I noticed tended to be heavier. So you want the one that actually is labeled, that it says you can use it for skin, hair, and as a carrier oil for massage, because those tends to be a little bit lighter and it feels smoother and it's more easily absorbed into the skin. Now, level 3 moisturizers is not recommended for oily, breakout prone skin. Now, the next one is one I have been using for a very, very long time, and this one is the Overnight Repair Cream. It's fragrance-free, paraben-free. The third ingredient is a vitamin C derivative, so it's more suitable for sensitive skin. It actually has several humectants. It has hyaluronic acid, glycerin, but it also has organic jojoba oil and sunflower oil. It also, in addition to that, has panthenol and MSM, which is otherwise known as dimethyl sulfone. Not cell phone, sulfone. This specific ingredient actually supports collagen formation and helps the skin to heal a lot faster. It decreases inflammation and enhances product or ingredient absorption. This is suitable for dry, sensitive skin, and this is what would be considered a level 2 moisturizer. So it is a good balance of humectants, emollients, and occlusives. Oily skin, I think it would suffice. You don't need a lot of this, because obviously you have oily skin and you're already probably making enough of this. So I think it would be suffice just to eat a diet that has a lot of the foods that contain the essential fatty acids. Now, unless you guys are unless you guys are using acne control products that are absorbing a lot of the oil, all you have to do is increase the amount of water or moisture that's on your skin. It'll slow down the sebum production, so you should be fine with that. So if you are not sure what level of moisturizer to use on your skin, whether it's dry skin or oily skin, I have both, but this particular one for dry skin, you can catch right here, because remember, makeup is an art and skincare is a science. So if you're not sure, oh, sorry, blanked out, sorry. Okay, sorry. I'm trying not to laugh here. Okay.